Hello friends, welcome back again. This video is in continuation to my previous other video, and wherein I discussed the components of a typical semi-through steel truss. Here we will focus some details about those components, and in this part of video I'll be focusing upon the bottom cord. So you can clearly see this bottom cord, which is spanning throughout the bridge, is a basically C-section. And I hope you can read it. It is sail C300 section used, which is placed back to back at certain distance, and effective battening. These are the batten plates which are provided at the bottom cord to connect these two channel sections that are placed back to back. And now focusing upon the connection details. See, this is the U0 joint which we normally refer when we design such structures. So in U0 joint, you can see one end breaker is coming, and a gusset plate is provided at the inner face of the C section, primarily because both the channel sections are welded or are placed back to back, and hence gusset has to be provided on the inside face so that a proper connection is made. So if you now focus on the bigger part of the picture, which is this number of bolts, you can count and see that there are roughly 15 number of bolts at the U0 joint, and this joint is basically to connect the end breaker and the bottom cord member, and that is it and serves no other purpose. However, now I will show you the spliced zone of this bottom cord, which will be having definitely more number of bolts than this. Please keep it keep a check that these are 50 number of bolts. Now this whole one segment is spanning throughout, and here is the first splice that was joint U0. This is joint U1, and this is the joint U2 where the bottom cord is spliced. Why do we need splicing? Because there are limited length, and we try to restrict our lengths to a certain minimum so that while construction and lifting and all those things, the weight is kept to a certain minimum, and also there is a limitation on the maximum length of the section that is available. So splicing is always encountered in steel structures, and if you will see this splice detail, which I am now bringing by a zoom section, so just count the number of bolts that are acting on the flange only of the bottom cord. If I am not wrong, these are 18 plus 18 on the both side, 36 and 6, 42 on the flange itself. And this joint is a double cover butt joint. As you can see, a cover plate has been provided, and in the splice zone, both on the outer face, and if I show you the inner face as well, the cover plate is provided. This is the gusset plate, which is acting as a cover plate as well, and here also the gusset and the butt and one additional cover plate is provided. So the number of cover plates is 2, and definitely slip resistance will be more because the number of interfaces available for shear failure of the bolt are more, and slip resistance will be more in a double cover butt joint section. And also you clearly see that instead of web, more bolts are provided on the flange. This is simply because in taking the axial tension, the flange area is way more than the, what we say, web area, and hence more tension is taken by the flange for the bottom cord member, and likewise these number of bolts are more on the flange. And also see, at the U0 joint only 15 bolts were sufficient to make a connection between the end breaker and the bottom cord, but at U2 joint where splicing is done, more than 15 bolts, that is 18 at one side or maybe 21 at one side and the other 21 at the other side of this section. You can clearly see these are two different bottom cords, and there is a gap between the two, and on each side of the gap at least 21 bolts are provided on the flange. So this is the detail I wanted to bring out, the difference between a splice zone and at the normal gusset junctions. So in the next part of my video, I will be discussing about the bottom bracing, which is present in this type of truss.